With me from SIMEC Atlantis on the line this morning, I've got Tim Cornelius. Tim, good morning.
Good morning.
Look, really a massive week for you last week. You and I spoke about this time last week to chat through the Equitex investment plus the Normandy deals. Last thing Friday, you had this news around SIMEC Green Highland Renewables. A big 5 days for you. Tell us a little bit more about what's involved in this latest announcement, Tim.
Andrew, it's been a huge week. Last week was probably the most important week in the history of Atlantis, as you say. Obviously, it began the week with an Equitex announcement in relation to Uskmas. We had the signing of the joint venture with the region of Normandy on Wednesday, and then it culminated on Friday afternoon, late Friday afternoon, with the announcement of the proposed acquisition of Green Highland Renewables, who we believe are one of the leading, if not the leading, developer of mini hydro projects in the United Kingdom.
And so tell us a bit more, what in fact are you acquiring here? What's the capacity?
So Green Highland have developed a substantial portfolio. We'll be acquiring 27.9 megawatts of mini hydro assets. Out of that, there's 20 megawatts of operating assets and a further 7.9 currently in construction. All of these projects are in Scotland, typically in the north in the Highlands.
And currently revenue generating, so upon completion, immediately earnings enhancing for SIMEC Atlantis.
Yeah, this will have a very profound impact on the group's financials. Obviously, it's an immediate positive contribution to group earnings. It'll have immediate contribution to positive group cash flow. And if you look at the equity cash yield, it's going to be very, very healthy at around 15%.
As far as some of the financials are concerned, you're looking to pay, what is it, just over £127 million for a portfolio generating £8 million a year. Is that not a bit steep?
No, not at all. So if you look at some of the comparables, the equity IRR at that valuation of 124.7 is incredibly high at about 17.5%. Some of the comparables like EDP Renewables or Folk Renewables traded more like 6.5 to 8%. So this is highly attractive. If you look at the steady state EV to EBITDA multiple, you're about 9.6%, which compares very, very well in the market. So these are high cash yielding, very, very predictable gold-plated assets.
And a mix of debt and equity you'll be looking to fund this acquisition?
Probably one of the most important parts of this deal. We've secured up to $95 million of very traditional bank finance to help us with this acquisition. And then obviously the balance we'll be looking to fund out of a combination of potentially script or equity. Or of course we can also use proceeds from the farm down of Uskmas, which we announced early last week.
That's right, and that was about £30 million, wasn't it?
That's correct, yeah.
When are you hoping for this deal to complete? When are you looking at?
So we'll be pushing very hard to try and get it rattled through before Christmas. We obviously appreciate that the world slows down in the second week of December. But we'll be pushing very hard for completion, if not by Christmas, early in the new year.
I suppose looking at the SIMEC Atlantis portfolio as it stands now, you've got tidal, you've got waste to energy, as of Friday, hydro. I suppose you're just missing wind and solar to some degree. I mean, does SIMEC have any of these assets you could potentially pick up?
They certainly do, and of course we've made it very, very clear from the outset, ever since we came out of suspension in June after the reverse takeover process, we're very committed to trying to build one of the largest independent generators in the UK, and we're well on our way.
Tim, nice to speak once again. Thanks for your time.
No, I appreciate your time. Thank you.